Today, the Phelps and Caldwell Blacks stand at the gateway to Red Wing's historic commercial district. But in 1866, when W.W. Phelps had a two-story structure built at 433 to 435 Main Street, it wasn't even part of downtown. The land was over Jordan. That is, it was set off from the rest of Main Street by a wide gully through which Jordan Creek flowed. The Jordan bisected Red Wing's early business district. Named by missionaries who built their homes at Bush and Third Streets on the east side of the gully in the 1850s, the Jordan bubbled forth near City Hall on 4th Street and made its way north to the Mississippi, entering the river near the train depot. To get to the other side of the deep ravine, people used stepping stones and later planks. Vehicles had to travel as far as 6th Street and back to reach the business district, especially during high water. As the city developed, crude wooden trestles were built on Main and 3rd Streets, but soon that wasn't enough. To unify downtown, the city gradually filled in the ravine, forcing the river underground, burying the river, and providing direct access to Phelps' round-arched Romanesque-style block. Made of masonry with a brick facade and limestone foundation, it had cut stone sills and a pressed metal cornice trim. The building had numerous tenants over the years, including grocers, meat markets, a battery shop, and even a hatchery. It's significant for its association with W.W. Phelps, who was elected in 1858 as one of Minnesota's two original U.S. congressmen. A prominent citizen and an attorney, he also supervised the U.S. Land Office and was involved in the grain trade and was co-founder of a railway and Red Wing Gas Company. Adjacent to the Phelps block is the Kogel block, an Italianate structure erected in 1874 by J. Christopher Kogel and his business partner Charles Betcher. A corner building at 437 to 439 Main Street, it had 6 front bays plus 9 side bays with cut stone keystones and a leaded glass transom and a patterned brick belt separating the floors. 2 upper floors were occupied by O.B. Dodge's boot and shoe factory, while the ground floor had 2 storefronts on Main and a 3rd rear storefront on Broad Street. A fire in 1882 damaged the 3rd story so that it had to be removed. Like its neighbor, the Kogel block had numerous tenants: restaurants, apartments, a secondhand store, a meat market, a tire store, a sporting goods store, and others. Most important are the early years when it was headquarters for the Betcher Sawmill, one of the first sawmills to start up in Red Wing and one of the longest operating lumber businesses. The storefronts of the 2 connected blocks have been substantially altered, but both buildings were restored in 2004. No trace of Jordan Creek is visible, although folks downtown say that sometimes they can hear it burbling in their basement.